Do you want to have a fast loading website? Well, in this video, I'm going to be showing you exactly how to do that thanks to SG Optimizer, which is a completely free plugin that you get with SiteGround's web hosting. Now, before I get into showing you exactly how to use SG Optimizer to get the best results for your website, let's look at why you'd want to. This is a dummy site that I made. I know it doesn't look very good, but it's going to give you the general idea. We've got up there a slideshow header, we've got a Google map, we've got some images, text boxes, and then we've got a basic gallery down there at the bottom. Now, if we run this through GT Metrics, which is a free tool you can use to test your website speed, we see that the results aren't very good at all. But then when I turn on the SG Optimizer plugin, suddenly that completely changes. Now these results can still be improved, and make sure to hang around to the end of the video because I'm going to share with you the other top three tips that I have to increase your website speed and boost up these results. But for now, let's dive into actually looking at SG Optimizer. So you've seen the difference that the SG Optimizer makes simply by turning it on to your website speed there from the GT Metrics report. This is the SG Optimizer, and you get this with SiteGround's web hosting. Okay, you can get SiteGround by going to jackinthenet.com/SG. Now you can get managed WordPress hosting here, and it is unbelievable value. I love SiteGround. I have an entire tutorial around this. But you get basically 70% off, and there's so much that you get with that hosting, okay? The SG Optimizer is just one of the things. I recommend that you go for the Grow Big plan here. You can always upgrade at any time, but most people won't need Go Geek. You get things like free SSL certificates, backups, which are going to be really important for what we're doing here, and of course, speed boosting caching. So when you've done that, you'll be able to access your site tools panel, which is what this is that we're looking at now. The first thing you want to do is create a backup. And the reason for that is when you're using a SG Optimizer, a couple of things here, like under the front end optimization, minifying JavaScript, deferring render blocking JavaScript, these are all things you're going to see really commonly on GT Metrics, Pingdom, Google PageSpeed Insights. Okay, they're the things that come up a lot, but they're also the things that can potentially cause problems with a website. They're probably not going to, but just to be safe, come on in, make a backup. SiteGround makes them automatically for you anyway, every day. But just before doing it for yourself, make a manual backup. I'm just going to call this one SG Optimizer. Create that. Boom, there we go. By the way, if you want to know exactly how to use all of this and where to find everything, that is in the tutorial. I'll post it on in the description below and also the card up in the top of the screen. Next, though, you just want to head over to the Speed tab. This is where you're going to find Cloudflare, which is the free CDN that you get with SiteGround as well, and caching. So go into this and just make sure that what you've got here is switched on. Okay, so make sure all of those are switched on just in case you're not seeing everything that you should be under the SG Optimizer plugin. But once you've done that, we're ready to roll. So under SG Optimizer, the first one is the Super Cacher settings. Turn both of these on. Down here, you've got browser-specific caching. Now, I would personally have that off because otherwise it's going to do a different cache for different browsers, and that's not as efficient. But otherwise, leave all of these at their default settings. Have Memcache on, and then head on over to the environment optimization. I won't bore you with exactly what all of these are. If you really want to know, I have an article on that. I'll put a link in the description, but that's going to go through with the screenshots exactly what each and every one of these does. But it's pretty self-explanatory anyway on here. It's just that you don't want to go crazy and turn all of them on. Some are more appropriate than others. For example, enable HTTPS. Have that on. You get a free SSL with SiteGround anyway. But leave this option off. We don't need that. Heartbeat optimization. This is a brand new feature with the new upgrade to SG Optimizer. If you want to learn about all those new features, I suggest the actual article that SiteGround have done themselves. Again, I'll put a link in the description. It's written by this gentleman over here, and it goes through the few new upgrades that they've done. But there's some powerful stuff in there. It's worth a couple of minutes to read that. But I would have all of these things on. So Heartbeat Optimizer, turn this on. Leave your admin page disabled and your front end disabled. However, come into the post and page edit and enable this. SiteGround reckons 180 seconds, so I'm not going to argue. We'll do that and confirm. But you do have to put it on because it's not on by default. We can turn this on if you've got things like subdomains. If you don't worry about it. And then this one's brilliant, scheduled database maintenance. Definitely have this on. This is going to automatically do a load of stuff for you and save you a lot of time. Okay, old posts, old pages, spam comments, all this sort of stuff is just taken care of automatically for you. And there's nothing more that you need to do on this page, so we can head on over to the front-end optimization. First up here, we have minify HTML. Definitely put this on. The same with minifying JavaScript files, and the same down here with minify CSS. You're going to see these a lot if you're doing speed tests, as I said, with the likes of Pingdom or GT Metrics. Now, this is where you've got to be careful. Combining JavaScript and defer render blocking. Again, this is going to come up a lot for you. When you turn these on, it comes up with a little warning. So when you've done this, you just want to go into your site and make sure that everything's still looking as it should be and it's all working properly. If it's not, that's why we created the backup just a minute ago, so you're safe and can always go back to that. Next, we've got combining CSS files, so I'm going to put this on as well, and the same for Google Fonts, and also removing query strings from static resources. We can also disable emojis as well if we want to. And then we've got media optimization. Again, this is just, I can't believe this is actually in this plugin. I think it's brilliant. So new image optimization, definitely turn this on. Existing image optimization. Okay, I've already done this for that GT Metrics thing that I showed you during the intro, but you can put this on here. Generate web copies of new images. I'll definitely do that. And again, I've already done this, generated myself WebP copies. I suggest that you do this as well. You can't upload WebP images to WordPress by default, which is really irritating because it's the form of file that browsers like Google are wanting to see. That's going to help your page rank better, but SG Optimizer can create those for you. So make sure to do that. And then you can also lazy load media as well. Just be careful with this one. I tend to have it on because it does help with loading times. But if you've got a lot of pictures on your website, if that's a big part of the design, what you don't want is for people to be scrolling down a lot and you've just got a lot of images and they're starting to load slowly. That's bad user experience, okay? Always think of the person that is actually on your website first and foremost. So just be a little bit careful with this one. And I should have mentioned as well, the optimization level that we have here for WebP copies, the default one of 75%, I've never had an issue with this. I think that it looks absolutely fine, but you can change this to a lossless optimization if you want. That's going to keep more of the quality of the images, but they're obviously going to be bigger in file size. So if you're a photographer and, you know, pixel perfect quality is what you're after, you might want to obviously not have a lossy compression, but otherwise go ahead and turn that on. And then on the last tab, we've got the inbuilt performance test. So this is where you can actually analyze here inside SG Optimizer, the speed of your website all down to Google page speed. So definitely make sure to use this and GT Metrics. Okay, that's the other free one you can be using to analyze your site and make sure you're getting it nice and speedy. So there we go. It really is that simple to speed up your website with SG Optimizer. Before you go though, here are the top three tips that I promised you. Now, these are just the start. There are loads of things. I'm going to be doing lots of videos on how to speed up your website, what the best free tools and premium ones are to do that. But these are your three basic building blocks. Do these right, you are going to see massive website speed improvements. Up first, we've got the CDN that comes for free with SiteGround's hosting again. Okay, use Cloudflare. That is going to speed up your website no end. It means that you're going to be serving up the website geographically to the closest possible place for the person who is visiting your site. So use Cloudflare. I'm going to do a separate video exactly on how to do that. Up next for number two, it's optimizing your images for free with Google Squoosh. Squoosh is something that's been developed by Google. You simply drag and drop your images in. It's going to optimize them, keeping amazing quality, but reducing the file size massively. Okay, if you use that combined with the WebP images that are being generated via the SG Optimizer we just looked at, you're going to massively reduce the file sizes. Again, I'm going to do a quick video showing you how to use Google Squoosh. It's simple and free to do. And up last, the third power tip is to use the right theme and plugins. Themes make a big difference when it comes to website speed. Now, the best ones for using a premium one is Divi. For free, you can be using Astra. You've also got Astra Pro, which is a premium version as well. But if you're after a free theme, then Astra is definitely the way to go. It's the best one on the market, it's really light. And for a premium one, Divi, again, really well built. These are built by the best designers in the world. They're gonna mean a responsive, speedy website right from the get-go. And the same goes for plugins. Try to keep them to a minimum, but for page builders, use Elementor. I have an entire tutorial series on how to use the free Elementor page builder, and if you use that, you are going to have a beautiful looking website. It's going to be responsive, it's going to load quickly on mobile, which is really important for your SEO results. And all around, it's going to boost the results that you get on your speed test tools like GTmetrics, like Pingdom, like Page Insights by Google. So I'm going to post the links to all of those in the description below. Make sure to check them out, and you're going to have a really fast loading website in no time at all. Thanks again for watching. Please like the video. Make sure to subscribe. That way you're not going to miss out when I am posting those tutorials for you. Hit the little bell icon so you get notified. And until next time, bye-bye.